Good evening, everyone. As we all know, this is the anniversary of D-Day. In the sort of important scheme of things, and almost as important, this is day three, week three of, I never remember the numbers. I'm ashamed to admit, humanity, is that right? Humanity 351. Don't ask me to do the title, but I know Myth in the World, the World of Myth, it's one of the two. I apologize for this. Even though at this point in the course, there's not really very much pressure on you yet. You know, everyone kind of knows that we're doing a semester project. That semester project is a scenario. The scenario is you're giving a talk to a bunch of experts on global mythology in Paris. And I'm doing my best to get us to Paris, but I have this feeling we're going to have to settle with Odenton, Maryland. My apologies in advance for that. The talk itself is roughly 10 minutes, and I want everyone to take really seriously the idea that it's a presentation to experts. Hi, how are you? Begin thinking about things like the tone of voice and things like that. Okay, so the talk itself is 10 minutes. The paper is really short. It's only 7 pages, and I intentionally did not make it 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. Pages because I wanted to keep you focused. Okay, the paper breaks down into two different hemispheres. The first part is the myth part, and one of the things that we need to talk about, or I need to go over again, is the difference between what I'm calling a historical myth and a contemporary myth. So we've talked about this a little bit, but I've got to begin to tighten that up, and I'll come back to that in a second. So that's one part, and just keep in mind, it's just 3 pages. So focus in this is really, really important. The second part is what we started by calling the political or social issue. Now, the one thing that I want to emphasize about the political or social issue is, it's kind of a negative and a positive. The negative part is, I don't want you to really say 2 words. One is society, okay? Because there's this temptation to sort of to talk about society without pinning it down and narrowing the scope, and that leads to problems that I'm going to talk about in a second. I also don't want you to say America, okay? I want positively, what I want you to do in terms of the political or social issue is basically identify a city and identify a time frame. I'm suggesting that you just do Metropolitan Washington in 2018, but I'm not wed to that at all. It's all right. It's all right. You can make it. You can situate it in another place, another time. I don't care at all. All I'd like to say about that is keeping the historical aspect, chronology of the time frame tight is better for you. Okay? Now, why am I insisting on the narrowed scope? There's a really simple reason for that, and that is if you leave it open, or if you say America or society, which everyone is tempted to go in that direction, that means there will inevitably be two difficulties. The first difficulty is it will be very hard to research and very time consuming to research. And the way I want you to research this, which I'll come back to in a second, will be impossible. So one is the time factor. The second part is keeping the relationship between the myth or the myth segments or the myth relationships onto the social or political problem really tight and easy to explain in 7 or 8 minutes will be easy if you keep everything focused. If not, as I'm saying, not only the research will be hard, but also to really be able to explain things will be essentially impossible. Okay, so that's the method in that madness. Now, I want to say something about the two forms that the myth can take. We've been talking, and this course is basically built to be a course on, hey, how are you? On what I'm calling the historical myths, that is, the Greek myths, the Roman myths, the myths of Oceania, the myths of Africa, the myths of the Native Americans, that are basically oral for a long time and then gradually get written in standard English, French, German, whatever, and now have a kind of media presence. Okay, that's sort of the way the course was geared. However, I'm very open to doing like contemporary myths, and whether that's the myth of New York City, or the myth of Nazis, or the myth of the Black Panthers. Does any, a couple of you have other, about tattooing. That's another one, it's really good, and I don't think that's exactly built into the original intention of the course, but I think it's totally appropriate. Now, the thing is, for those of you who are doing it roughly, very roughly, half the class is doing contemporary myths. And for those of you, the one thing is, so once again, negative and positive, the negative is what I don't want you to, well, let me say it like this, is what I want you to be wary of. That is just making the myth up as though, because it's obvious to you, it's obvious in general. That's what you don't want to do, just being arbitrary and saying, well, everyone knows the myth. What I want you to do is do a little bit of research and use the Nazis. We were talking about this last week. And so you're doing the racism in the Nazis, and you're identifying that as a kind of myth. Just make sure you research racism in the Nazis enough to identify three relatively stable aspects of that myth. Okay, and that's easy. As I was saying to a couple of you, I mean, I think the research that goes into the mythology part of this, I mean, should take like a weekend at the most. And like your focus part should take even less. Okay, what do I mean by the focus part? And this is whether it is a contemporary or a historical myth. You basically will need to come up with three very precise and specific aspects of the myth. And whether it's the Algonquins and, help me,
Wendigo.
And Wendigo, or the Nazis, or tattoos, or Demeter, you're still going to have to come up with three precise aspects of it. Now, the thing that I'm emphasizing here, and this really works to your advantage, is I'm really relaxed about the scholarship part of that. I want you to simply get some sources and have use the sources to kind of combine with your own intuition and your own understanding to come up with a kind of portrait of the mythological figure, the myth, whatever it happens to be, and not to worry so very much about some scholar disagreeing with you, okay? I mean, not only is the semester too short, but I think in this matter, for reasons that I'll continue to bring out, that is in the matter of mythology, conventional scholarship is really unreliable, and we'll talk about that later. Okay, so this week is really important because basically you need to get a grip on the mythology part, and you need to begin thinking about the the time frame and the place for your political or social problem. Okay, so even though there's not too much pressure on you, and did you see how much template one counted? Did everyone notice?
10 points.
I had to laugh at this because I did not do that. Usually, here, let me say something here. I usually go through the scoring and I change it all. You know, I change the department scoring entirely. One of the things I always do is change the 40% discussion down to what I can get away with, you know, depending on, of course, depending on the timing, depending on, you know, whether there's someone looking at my courses. It, you know, it'll be 30, 20. I've pushed it to 10, everyone, from a couple of times. I've gone to 7.5 and waited for, but no one's there, no one cares. Okay. And they trust my judgment. That's the other thing. I have good reasons for doing that. That's pretty much, any questions before we sign on? This is a little longer than I wanted. Okay, great, thanks. Thank you.